Envision a situation in which a swarm of 200 naval drones, deployed from a warship, silently navigates the ocean, patiently monitoring maritime threats and poised to eliminate an enemy vessel when necessary. The U.S. Navy is collaborating with the defense industry to develop autonomous naval drones capable of swarming. This initiative aims to counterbalance the numerical advantage held by the Chinese Navy in the Indo-Pacific region. Defense Innovation Unit, DIU's, Prime, production-ready, inexpensive, maritime expeditionary, will buy drones in bulk to respond to a Navy operational need for small autonomous attack craft capable of intercepting enemy vessels at high speeds. The Defense Innovation Unit has already issued a request for companies to propose ideas for compact, unmanned surface vehicles. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the U.S. Navy plans to take on China with a naval drone swarm. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The U.S. Navy, traditionally uncontested in Asian waters, is now confronted with a formidable Chinese Navy that exceeds American warship production. According to the Pentagon's annual report released in October, China has expanded its fleet to over 370 ships and submarines, a significant increase from 340 in 2023, solidifying its position as the world's largest navy in terms of numerical strength. While the U.S. Navy remains the most potent navy in terms of tonnage and capabilities, China is expanding rapidly. China has been using its naval might to dominate the South China Sea region and could potentially use it to invade Taiwan. The U.S. Navy is currently exploring a drone concept known as Hellscape in the Pacific region, aiming to disrupt China's potential amphibious invasion of Taiwan through a combination of loitering munitions and attack drones. Naval analysts anticipate that swarms of economic drones could present a significant challenge to submarines. These swarming drones are envisioned to be compact, lightweight, and cost-effective, operating in a coordinated manner similar to bees within the same hive when networked together. Whether released from submarines, large drone motherships, or warships, these expendable drones could number in the hundreds. Scattered across the ocean, these swarming systems offer prolonged surveillance capabilities and can adapt their movements based on operational needs. The Defense Innovation Unit aims to commence production of these low-cost platforms as early as next year. The goal is to manufacture 10 or more systems per month, resulting in an annual production rate of 120 or more such drones. Prime USVs represent a departure from the U.S. Navy's current deployment of large and medium USV demonstrators, featuring reduced endurance and a range spanning 500 to 1,000 nautical miles, or around 925 kilometers to 1,950 kilometers. These specified requirements entail the drones autonomously navigating contested areas, lingering in assigned locations, identifying surface threats, and subsequently accelerating to a minimum of 35 knots or 40 miles per hour or 65 kilometers per hour for the interception of enemy vessels. According to the solicitation, the drone should also demonstrate the ability to collaborate with others in groups, executing intricate autonomous maneuvers that adapt to the dynamic and evasive movements of pursued vessels. Although not explicitly articulated in the solicitation, the operational characteristics during the small USVs' sprint and intercept phases resemble those of a suicide surface attack drone, as observed in instances such as Ukraine. The solicitation includes desirable features, such as the capacity to carry small unmanned aerial systems for spotting enemy vessels or aiding in other missions, as well as the ability to support various sensors and weapons. Deployment options range from well decks to boat davits, with the provision for long-term storage in a standard shipping container. Specialized software for the collaborative intercept capability is covered in the solicitation, enabling the drones to autonomously swarm with other USVs to pursue their targets. While the concept is being put forward formally now, the U.S. military has been working on this for some time. During this month's Surface Navy Association Symposium, the Naval Sea Systems Command showcased a demonstration conducted by the U.S. 4th Fleet last fall. In the demonstration, Textron's Common Unmanned Surface Vehicle, equipped with a Korean rocket system, successfully engaged a target as part of a kill chain demonstration. Demonstrations featuring unmanned surface vehicles, USVs, from Sail Drone and MARTAC have been carried out, including in Task Force 59 within U.S. Central Command. In November, a MARTAC Devil Ray USV launched loitering munitions during Exercise Digital Talon in the Middle East. During a speech to commemorate the Communist Party's 100-year anniversary in 2021, Chinese President Xi Jinping stated, "Resolving the Taiwan question and realizing China's complete reunification is a historic mission and an unshakable commitment of the party." In 2023, Xi said on the opening day of the week-long, key, once-in-a-five-year Congress of the ruling Communist Party of China, CPC, "We will not renounce the use of force, and we will take all necessary measures to stop all separatist movements in Taiwan." So the threat is very real. Kamikaze naval boats have already made a mark in Ukraine. On the 29th of October, the home of the Russian Navy's Black Sea Fleet in Sevastopol, Crimea, came under attack with the utilization of this kind of craft. During the night of January 31st to February 1st, 2024, a daring operation conducted by Group 13 of the Special Intelligence Unit of the Ukrainian Ministry of Defense took out the Russian Black Sea Fleet's corvette Ivanovets. The attack took place at the roadstead of Lake Donislav in Crimea, which is currently occupied by Russia. The Ukrainian Military Intelligence Directorate, GRU, announced that it has carried out this operation using a group of unmanned boats. People's Liberation Army Navy warships and amphibious landing crafts will have to cross the 100 miles or 160 kilometer wide Taiwan Strait to mount an invasion. This is where autonomous naval drones could play a crucial role.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.